Hello everyone, and welcome back to Everyday Husband Quotes, the channel for marriage advice, marriage entertainment, and everything else, marriage. Hey, hey guys, and welcome back to the channel. Now, Kenya Moore said something so profound last night on The Real Housewives of Atlanta. You know, we just got off this whole Kenya versus Ken episode, which in my humble opinion, I believe Ken is Kenya's alter ego. Beyonce has Sasha fears, and honey, Kenya Moore has Ken. No shade, but I'm just saying what I'm saying, y'all. But last night on the show, she said to Cynthia Baily that I want to have my fairy tale like I had before.
Does it scare you?
Yeah. I don't want to be single, you know, but I want to have my fairy tale like I had, you know. I feel like, you know, I definitely want to make it work, but.
Well, do you think he wants to?
I'm not sure.
So let me know what y'all think about all of that. For me, everyone has a honeymoon part in their relationship. If you're lucky, you get two. And if you're very lucky, the honeymoon will continue forever. Cynthia Baily said right after Marc kicked the production company out last night on the show, after the dinner ended for the charity event, that things got really bad between Kenya and Marc. She said, "We only got a small portion of what really was going on, but that it heated up and things got really bad between Kenya and Marc that same night. And then the next day is when they made that public announcement to the world on social media that they were getting a divorce." Another thing that I want to point out really quickly is that Kenya wanted to plan the charity event from the very beginning. Now, she did step back a little bit like a true wife should so that Marc could step up and be the leader. But truth is, Kenya said she had to step back in at the last minute to get everything to come together because Marc had dropped the ball and he did not do everything he was supposed to do to make this event come together and happen. That's why we saw Kenya trying to get his suit together at the last minute. He said he had told Kenya 3 days ago that he needed his suit, but she was like, "No, you just told me you needed me to get you something together to wear to the event," which is what I did. Which again, y'all, 3 days is not a long time. It's all last minute to me. But Kenya also on the show last night was calling people like the caterers and the planners to confirm the event with them. And we saw that, you know, on the show for ourselves while she was driving in her car. So to me, she did step up and make things happen. Which again, in my humble opinion, Marc dropped the ball last night and Kenya had to pick up the pieces to get everything together. I think she did really well on that aspect. But at the end of the day, who really knows why Marc was so angry that night and why he was acting like a real weirdo that day. I mean, it could have been he was having a bad day or something, but it definitely seems like it was more to the story that was actually being said. And for me, I think the red flags that y'all talk about in the comment section of some of the other videos that I've done on The Real Housewives of Atlanta, I think the red flags were there from the beginning. So I'm gonna read three comments here that were left in another video about Kenya and Marc, and then we're gonna go ahead and wrap up this video, y'all. Now, someone says Marc does not like to be forced into the public eye. He views Kenya's career choices and character as attention-seeking behavior. Someone else said that there also should have been signs of his disrespect even before the marriage, and either they weren't dating long enough to figure out these problems or they both just overlooked them. And then one last person said, if Marc Daly ever loved Kenya, he sure did not show it. What husband does not support his wife? He never compromised with Kenya. I never saw any display of affection as a newlywed. No googly eyes, passionate kisses, soft touch from him. Zip, zilch, nada. Poor Kenya never had good skills in choosing men. So y'all, I'm gonna go ahead and wrap up this video, but you know, let me know what you all think about all of this. I will say last night was very sad for me. I can't really believe that the Housewives allowed for that to portray on the show, but this is reality TV. I mean, Kenya and Mark are not the first couple to have their relationship displayed like that on TV, and it's unfortunate that they're not going to be the last couple. But we can talk about all of that in the comments section. As always, thank you guys for watching, and I will talk to you guys in the next video. Bye. Bye.